They wrestled each other from the time they were little, and so we watched them wrestle, and some friends of theirs, or it was brought up at school about the little Blazers wrestling, so they went and tried it, and they absolutely loved it.
That love for wrestling took Ryan and Logan to the state championship. Nikki describes what it was like to watch two of her sons compete against each other.
It was very emotional because you don't want either one of your kids to lose, but we knew that one of them had to.
Losing a wrestling match soon became the furthest thing from the Burchards' minds.
We woke up Christmas morning. He was complaining of a side ache. He started getting worse and worse. He was kind of hunched over. He was pale looking. He had like little bruises on his arm.
His family rushed him to Dubuque to find that his spleen and liver were twice their normal size.
His platelet level was at 2,000, which normally would be up around 100 to 200,000. On New Year's Eve, we were informed that he had leukemia. He was full of cancer.
Ryan was diagnosed with AML, a rare form of leukemia usually found in adults.
It was devastating news, but they've given us a lot of hope here.
Nikki and Sean saw a silver lining.
Ryan is an inspiration to not only us, but the whole entire community. And the support's been awesome for Ryan.
He's positive. He's the most positive person I've ever met these days. I mean, he wakes up with a smile.
Ryan is expected to make a full recovery, but all the Burchards can do now is wait.
There's no way to tell. Everything looks good so far, but that is our goal. That's the doctor's goal.
As far as wrestling, everyone is determined to get Ryan back on the mat.
I think watching his brother wrestle this year and not being able to has been hard for him. So I think he definitely has the fire to get back out there again.